At least five are dead due to Typhoon Egai, two more injured. The country's disaster management agency says the reported casualties are victims of landslides that happened in Rizal and Benguet, but it notes the cases are still up for validation. Damage assessment also underway.
Reports are still coming in. Damages to infrastructure po is 1.7 million. Hindi pa po tayo nakakapagkuha ng reports sa agrikultura kasi we are still deploying po, about to deploy our rapid assessment. Kahit na po papalabas na po no, si Egay, pero meron po tayong binabantayan na isa pang sama ng panahon na posible pong pumasok sa ating Philippine Area of Responsibility. Nandyan pa rin po yung habagat. So sa mga kababayan po natin in affected areas, tayo po ay patuloy na mag-monitor sa mga announcements, sa mga information. At lalo na po no, kung tayo po ay palilikasin or i-request na lumikas muna sa mga ligtas na lugar, wag na po tayo mag-atubili. Para po kapag tayo po ay ligtas, maililigtas po natin yung ating pamilya at yung ating komunidad.
The Social Welfare Department, meanwhile, vows to ramp up efforts to help residents affected by the typhoon. The agency said the number of individuals affected by the storm has now reached over 342,000. Nearly 27,000 have been displaced. Relief assistance worth over 10 million pesos have also been distributed.
We're very happy to inform the public. Siyempre, yung ating pong pangulo, ito po yung atas talaga sa atin to make sure na yung sinasabi nga po natin na omnipresent po tayo hangga't maaari, nandun po tayo sa lahat ng pangangailangan ng ating mga kababayan. Sa ngayon po ay nasa 1.2 billion pesos po yung halaga ng naka-preposition po natin na mga family food packs. 1.2 million po ito na mga family food packs o relief goods na nakakalat po sa buong bansa at maaari po natin gamitin. Bukod po dyan, may 175 million tayo na quick response fund na maaari natin gamitin sa iba pa pong mga form na mga assistance kagaya po ng cash for work kung kakailanganin, food for work at emergency cash transfer.
Well, Typhoon Egai has left the Philippine area of responsibility, but there's another incoming storm. A resident meteorologist, Ariel Rojas, joins us now to tell us more about this. Ariel.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. Typhoon Egai, with a traditional name Doksuri, left the Philippine area of responsibility at 8 this morning. However, it will continue to bring heavy rains and gusty conditions in northwestern Luzon. Doksuri was last located 255 kilometers west of Itbayat, Batanes, with maximum winds of 150 kilometers per hour and gusts up to 185 kilometers per hour. It is currently moving north-northwest toward the speed of 15 kilometers per hour and is forecast to make landfall over southeastern China Friday morning. Due to the sheer size of its wind field, signal number 2 remains hoisted over Batanes, northwestern Cagayan, and northern Ilocos Norte. Wind signal number 1, meanwhile, is still in effect over the rest of Cagayan and Ilocos Norte, Ilocos Sur, La Union, Pangasinan, Abra, Apayao, Kalinga, Mountain Province, Ifugao, Benguet, Isabela, Nueva Vizcaya, Quirino, and northern parts of the provinces of Aurora, Nueva Ecija, and Tarlac. All kinds of sea vessels are still not allowed to sail in areas under wind signals, and the seas of central Luzon, Calabarzon, Mimaropa, Bicol region, and western Visayas also remain a no-sail zone for small boats. Heavy torrential rains from the typhoon and the southwest monsoon or habagat it enhances will still batter Ilocos region and parts of Cordillera, Cagayan Valley, central Luzon, Mimaropa, and western Visayas. So flooding and landslides remain a threat in these areas. Habagat will continue to affect Luzon and western Visayas until this weekend, and gusty conditions and scattered monsoon rains are expected. And meanwhile, the low pressure area outside of the country developed into a tropical depression. The disturbance was located 1,585 kilometers east of eastern Visayas at 10 this morning. It may enter the PAR with a typhoon strength late Saturday or Sunday morning and will be named Falcon. It will neither approach nor hit the country but will pull the habagat. It may make landfall over Ryukyu Islands and exit the PAR Tuesday next week. Please continue monitoring for updates. That's the latest on the weather. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Our resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas there joining us live. Over in Benguet, four people are confirmed dead and another one is missing due to Typhoon Egai. Around 200 are also staying in evacuation centers. 90% of Baguio also without power. Governor Melchor Dicla says they are still studying whether they will place the province under a state of calamity.
halos lahat po yung mga kalsada natin, provincial road, national road, nagsara po talaga lahat kahapon, pero dinahandaan po ng DPWH sa probinsya, sa munisipyo, unti-unti pong binubuksan natin. Sa lakas po ng ulan at sa kahangin, malaki po talaga yung pinsala dun sa mga halamanan po natin dito sa Benguet.
One person was killed in a landslide in the town of Montauk in Mountain Province. Let's get more details on that as well as the situation in Isabela. Our very own Harris Julio now joins us. Harris, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, good morning. A casualty due to the onslaught of Super Typhoon Egay was reported in Mountain Province. According to the Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office, a man died due to a landslide in Sitio Pakil, Kalutit, Bontok around 4:20 p.m. yesterday. The 30-year-old victim was sheltering in a hut with two other individuals when the landslide occurred. The body of the victim was recovered after several hours of search and rescue operation. He was taken to the hospital but was declared dead on arrival by the attending physician. The PDRRMO advises residents who live in landslide-prone areas to take extra precautions now that rains are still being experienced. Several roads in Bontok are impassable due to landslide. The recent one occurred just this morning at around 10:37 a.m., which rendered the Bontok-Banawi Road impassable. Clearing operation is underway. Meanwhile, it is still a bit cloudy, but weather has generally improved here in Isabela. Power supply and communication lines are stable. All major roads and bridges are also passable, according to the Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council. The swollen rivers have also started subsiding, but we are still getting an update on the situation of the Santo Domingo-Santiago Overflow Bridge in Quirino Town, which according to the MDRRMO remains submerged by floodwater at around 7 o'clock this morning. The province recorded one casualty in the town of Ramon, wherein the victim was hit by a toppled coconut tree during the onslaught of Super Typhoon Egay. Over in Nueva Vizcaya, responders from the Bureau of Fire Protection Solano successfully rescued three individuals who were trapped in their house that had been struck by felled trees in Barangay Poblacion North yesterday. The Pangasinan-Nueva Vizcaya National Highway remains impassable as of the moment to give way for the clearing operation. Clearing operation is also underway to open the roads in Cayapa and Ambaguio Town, which were blocked by landslide. According to DPWH Region 2, there are about 61 million pesos reported damage to national roads in the province of Nueva Vizcaya. There are also about 500 million pesos worth of damage in flood control facilities. Meanwhile, work in government offices there has resumed today.
Well, cleanup operations have begun in Apari, Cagayan as the weather there improves. Rafael Bosano now joins us with the latest from there. Raf, what more can you tell us? Raf?
Carmina, hello, Carmina.
Yeah, go ahead. We can hear you now.
Yeah, the weather is much fairer now here in Apari, Cagayan, but those living in evacuation centers cannot go home just yet. We spoke a while ago to Municipal Administrator Attorney Jane Tadili, and she says assessments are still being made to ensure that it is safe for residents to go home along the coastlines. She says that around 1,000 houses have been partially damaged, while at least 9 are totally damaged, and these houses are made of light materials. Assessments are also being made on agricultural damages, and so far no casualties have been reported. But just a while ago, we were in Barangay Talungan in Apari, where members of the Philippine Coast Guard surveyed a portion of the Cagayan River. An elderly woman who was collecting pieces of wood was said to have fallen into the river and got drifted away by the strong current. The chairman of Barangay Talungan says the chances of finding the elderly woman is slim, as the incident happened at 7 this morning. And even if the weather has calmed in Apari, they will still report this as typhoon-related. Right now, we're experiencing intermittent rain, which is why he continues to remind the public to stay away from the Cagayan River. We're also en route to Abulug in Cagayan following reports of extreme flooding to find out how the residents are getting by. And just by passing the highway, we already saw several houses submerged. Half of the homes are submerged in floods. So So we will be finding out more from local officials after we get down.
Today, more than 2,000 are staying in evacuation centers in Ilocos Norte, which has been hit with severe flooding. Randy Minor now joins us with an update. Randy.
Yes, Carmina. More than 2,000 individuals in different cities and municipalities in Ilocos Norte remains in the evacuation center. These individuals were evacuated Tuesday night due to flooding and strong winds brought by Super Typhoon Egay. Relief operations and food packs were given to the evacuation centers. Ilocos Norte is already under a state of calamity and remains at the red warning level, indicating the occurrence of severe flooding and landslides in flood and landslide-prone areas in the province. According to the Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council, or PDRMC, there are no reported casualties yet in the province due to typhoon Egay. PDRMC is expecting heavy damage in agriculture and infrastructure due to the strong winds and flood caused by the super typhoon. As of now, there's no electricity in the whole province of Ilocos Norte. Meanwhile, Ilocos Sur is also under a state of calamity due to strong rains and flooding. And that's the latest in the Ilocos Norte and Ilocos Sur. Reporting for ANC, Randy Menor, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Randy, and take care. Over 20 road sections in Luzon remain impassable after sustaining damage due to Egay. Meanwhile, hundreds remain stranded in ports because of the wicked weather. Let's get more details now from Jackie Manaba, who joins us on the line. Jackie?
Carmina's Super Typhoon Egay, one of the strongest storms to hit the country this year, has left a trail of destruction impacting roads, ports, and airports. The storm brought torrential rains, powerful winds, and massive waves, causing widespread damage to critical infrastructure. The Department of Public Works and Highways identified 27 road sections that were rendered impassable due to flooding, landslides, and fallen trees. These roads are located in Cordillera Administrative Region, Regions 1, 2, and 3. The heavy rainfall caused rivers to overflow, submerging roads and cutting off access to several communities. The agency said they are working tirelessly to clear the debris and restore connectivity, but the extent of damage is slowing their efforts. Some ports along the coast have ceased operations since Monday, disrupting maritime trade and transportation. However, as the weather cleared this morning, ships have started to sail, significantly decreasing the number of stranded passengers in ports to 500 from 3,000 yesterday. Airports in the path of Super Typhoon Egay, specifically in northern Luzon, have faced numerous challenges as well. The strong winds and heavy rainfall forced the cancellation of numerous flights at Naia, Tobasco, Lawag, Masbate, El Nido, and Romblon. There were also cancellations at the airports in Naga and Masbate. Airport authorities are working diligently to fix the damaged ceiling of the Lawag Airport, but they said that it may take some time before normal operations can resume.